Disha.
I'm Sandeep.
I'm Atira.
And I'm Rachit, and we're from Harvest International School, Grade 8.
Our school has made several innovative ideas to help the community overcome water scarcity. One of the projects we've made is the low-cost water sand biofilter. It involves components like sand, gravel, and charcoal to filter the water. By just letting water seep through the different layers of sand, we obtain potable drinking water.
Our school also worked on a waterless urinal. This urinal was very low cost and had almost no maintenance. This, because it has no maintenance, has a lot of possibility for usage in government schools. Hence, it has been used in multiple schools in Bangalore and Hubli.
Our school has also made models of grey water harvesting system. Now, what is grey water? There are three types of water: black water, grey water, and white water. Black water is a type of contaminated water, whereas pure water is the cleanest form of water which we consume. Grey water is just in between them. Now, the water we waste while washing our hands from the wash basin is a form of grey water. This grey water can also be used for other activities such as gardening, washing our vehicles, and in this case, for flushing. In this model, we use the otherwise waste grey water and simply direct it to the flush tank via a valve. There is a valve at the bottom of the flush tank to remove water in case the flush tank gets full. Now, this is a similar concept that was implemented in Japan, but of course, this is a low-cost solution of that. Now, using this concept, we can save thousands of liters that go into the drain every single day. And thus, we can implement them in government schools and villages.
So I'm going to be talking about another project which we did called as the water meter. So basically we connected an LCD display to a water pump which was connected to a tap. So whenever the tap was on, it would display how much of water was being flowed. So during that time, the person washing their hands could understand how much of water they're using, and it subconsciously reduce the amount of water they're using and save a lot of water. Thus, we can help our society by helping people around us with their day-to-day problems.